besties. How are my besties doing? Woo! Spend 20 minutes telling you just how good I am.
Right. I'm so excited. Right.
And you guys need to. I love you so much.
No, the service dog.
Oh, I love the service dog. Fantastic. Can't wait to get closer to the service dog. Yeah. Anyway, besties, this is how we talk to each other now. This is how Gen Z talks to each other. Do we like it? Or do we feel like it's a patronizing, forced sense of intimacy? Yeah. I'll let you imagine which one I think it is. I like Gen Z because I'm scared of them, and I'm impressed by them because you guys have this like effortless way of being sarcastic in the way you talk. And it's like so beautifully passive, so sweetly sarcastic. It's like you guys all talk like a bunch of Chandlers and you dress like a bunch of Rachels. And it's confusing to me because I'm a millennial. Woo! And we are the Ross. Because we started off pretty cool, and then as the years went on, we just like tripled down on our neuroses to the point that we are uncomfortable to be around physically. No, I really, really appreciate it. This show, as you've seen, is a lot about checking in with each other. And I feel like it is my responsibility to do the checking in, because every time I post something online, someone immediately says, "Are you okay?" And to that I say, I think so. I think I'm okay. I'm as okay as like an Enya song. Like, I'm mostly chill. But then I'm just also completely unsettled sometimes. But I guess that's what you get when you've been making content on the internet for 15 years. Crazy. Been making YouTube videos for 15 years. Some of you were probably 15 years old when you came across any of the content.
Younger.
And to that I say, where were your parents? More importantly, where were my parents? As Enya would say, who can say? No, it's been absolutely incredible to be working on the internet for so long, because I loved the internet. I grew up incredibly shy and insecure and introverted. Not much has changed. But I love the internet because it gave me this, you know, safe space to express myself. And I expressed myself. I expressed myself, and I expressed myself, and I expressed myself. I was like the healthiest pair of anal glands on the dog. And it was really great for a long time. And then it started to feel confusing because I had built this brand off of this idea of myself as an authentic version of myself. I was very drilled into just be yourself online. Oh my God, I'm getting connections with people because I'm being authentically myself. I didn't realize that I was building a persona of myself that I was like overly identifying with and putting all my value into and all my self-worth. This is gonna be a good story, so don't fear, okay? I was so just caught up in this version of myself that only existed online, this idea that my value was only available in this form. And I got really sad and confused and concerned that who am I if I'm not on the internet? And you get caught up in this idea of hustle culture, this go, 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 more, 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 create, create, create. You are only as worthy or valuable as the opportunities that you are getting and taking. And it is exhausting, because how can you possibly be present and appreciative of yourself, of your work, of your relationships, if you are constantly told to go, 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 break through this wall, you know, break through this door? I mean, do you think the Kool-Aid man is a happy thing? That old jug of juice has been operated as a cry for help for years. Someone take that fucking thing into desert, give it some shrooms, let it find itself for a second. Or learn how to use a door handle. I don't know. Anyway, I started to feel really stuck and sad and confused and lost, and I did what anyone would do in that situation. I applied for grad school. And I have learned that grad school is like education bangs. This'll fix it. I'm not feeling too good. This'll make it better. Grad school's crazy. Is anyone here in a... Yeah. What are you doing here? Go write your papers. We're also in such a smart city, so I am so intimidated by you guys. I signed up for a program that is now called Depth Psychology and Creativity.
Ooh.
Yeah, it was originally called Engaged Humanities and the Creative Life. Fucking Hogwarts. But one of the reasons that I signed into this program is like, I knew I was feeling stuck, but I really understood that I was stuck because I was spending the majority of my days just walking around in my giant comfy I got from Shark Tank, like a fucking Dementor, just playing Scrabble Go against my fiance and my mom all day. And playing Scrabble Go against only your fiance and your mom is not the sign of a crisis. It's when you buy in-app purchases to beat your fiance in Scrabble Go, that might be the sign of a crisis. So. Grad school. And in my program, one, we're studying creativity, but we're also depth psychology, which investigates, explores the unconscious. You know, this wild world in our brain where these completely chaotic and inexplainable thoughts, patterns, behaviors, ideas, fantasies live. It's a little bit like Hogwarts. And understanding like how that connects to us as our deeper selves, how that connects to our creativity and our relationships. And one of the coolest parts about the program for me has been learning about the concept of soul, not the film, which I very much like, but similar to that, soul being this concept, not a tangible thing, but instead like a way that you view the world, yourself, your relationships. It's this intangible essence that makes your experiences meaningful, makes your work meaningful, makes your relationships meaningful. It is the most beautiful concept to me. And in learning about that, I realized, where did mine go? Oh, shoot. Did I leave it at TSA? No? Okay. So this essence has been gone for a little bit. Huh, that's interesting to find out. And I started to investigate, like, why do I feel this way? And I think, for sure, I think like the internet stuff like chipped away at it a little bit, but not all at once, okay? I do think that the internet kind of, without me being conscious of my participation in it, chipped away at my essence of soul. The same way, like when I get high at night, and I decide, it's time for some Oreos. And they're in that closet over there. So I, in my comfy, get up off the couch and I make my way over to the Oreos. And I open the cabinet and there's a whole box. I take just one because I'm not a fucking monster. I take one and then I make my way back to the couch. But suddenly the journey is difficult and arduous and is a little more challenging than I thought. And we need sustenance to survive, so I eat the Oreo. And I finally make my way back to the couch, and by the time I sit down, I look at my hands, there's no Oreo. What the hell am I doing? I go back to the cabinet to finish the mission that I started. I grab one Oreo because I'm not a fucking monster. And I make my way back to the couch, but the air conditioning's on and the friction of the air is so difficult for me. Oh, my muscles are straining. I must eat to survive, and I eat the Oreo. I get back to the couch and I look at my hands and there's no Oreo. We gotta go back to this cabinet. And I get one Oreo and I start to make my way back to the couch, but my calves can't handle it. I look at my dog. Should I eat the dog? No, that will be bad for me and dog. So instead, I eat the Oreo, and then I finally get to sit back on the couch, and Elliot's like, sit fucking down. I'm trying to watch the finale of Survivor. Great season, by the way. It's like that. The internet kind of chipped away at my soul a little bit. I've been doing lots of different things to try and get this soul energy back for me. I've been doing graduate school. I have not been doing yoga because that's stupid and I hate it. But I will say that I do love child's pose. That's my favorite thing. And I will teach you the best way that you can do child's pose. Okay, so let's imagine we're in a yoga studio. Oh gosh. My chakras. Okay, child's pose. Like that, you never have to go back to that yoga class again. So I've been doing grad school, haven't been doing yoga, and I've been doing something else, therapy. Woo! Huge fan of therapy. I love my therapist. Her name is Laura. I love her because I'm pretty sure she knows that I lie to her. No, I don't think she knows that I lie. I think she knows that I omit very important information that could help her help me. But I'll never know. I'm not going to ask her if she knows. She's the one that's supposed to ask questions. That's her job. Instead, I will build up this narrative in my head that she knows, and she's waiting for me to break down and tell her. And we will both be at a resistance. And I will build up that she knows, she knows, she knows into such an intense falsified narrative that it now becomes my truth. And I now hate Laura. And you know what? I should never speak to her again because she's toxic and bad for me. And I'll cut her off completely. No emails, no phone numbers, nothing. And that's what psychologists call a Libra. I love therapy. I've considered being a therapist. And I can't. I can't because if there's any therapists out there, yeah, I admire so much what you do. You're an everyday superhero to me. I can't do what you do because I cannot keep a secret. Like, you just hear everyone's absolute shit and you just keep it to yourself. That's incredible. I couldn't do that. I also couldn't help myself from just constantly diagnosing people in the real world, which you're not allowed to do. I would just be like, family trauma, eating disorder, narcissistic personality disorder, YouTuber, 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 YouTuber. So I can. So that's the journey I've been on, and thank you for listening to the verbal version of this. I think sometimes it's easy or better to express kind of the more artistic side of the journey, which I'm learning in graduate school. So I've also prepared a, you can say, oh no, out loud, and I will hear you. I've prepared an artistic kind of dance that explores the journey that I've had with YouTube and all of it. So, okay. Yes, Val, hit it.
Look at this stuff. Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl?